This I'll get you other exclusive visuals, in fact, of the CRPF all locked in a battle with stone pelters. CRPF men seen, that you'll currently see on your screens, they're pelting stones at houses in the Rambagh area of Srinagar. We can tell you that the area witnessed frequent clashes all through the day, but this is clearly not an act of retaliation or a precautionary measure. The CRPF, in fact, men caught on camera, they're pelting stones at residential blocks without any provocation. So those are the pictures there. A different side to the story that you can see. We've highlighted those pictures for you. CRPF men caught on camera pelting stones at residential blocks without being provoked. So here, raising serious questions. Why were they doing that? This has been a perennial argument between protesters and the CRPF. So these pictures caught on tape of the CRPF throwing stones at a house, a residential block there. Such behavior clearly a breach of standard procedures and only complicates problems, especially in a sensible state like JNK. So have a look at those pictures once again, just throwing stones there, flinging them into that neighborhood, residential neighborhood, CRPF personnel there for you. Now, earlier we spoke to the PDP spokesperson and President Rala Rimwa Mufti of the current unrest in the valley. Let's listen in to what she told us a little while ago.
When the state government or the forces, it seems that there is a war-like situation with your own population, and as you have been showing on your screen, I mean, this is not for the first time that forces, whether they are the police or the security forces, they are pelting stones. You know, it has been happening all the time, but that today the NewsX has been able to, we are bold enough, and they have, I don't know how they have been allowed to go there and, you know, catch this on the camera. It's happening all the time. I mean, it is not, well, that's what is, you know, making people more angry. They also, you know, barge into the houses and smash everything that comes in their way. And in fact, the three people who were killed in Anantnag, they were not a part of, you know, the stone pelters. They were chased and they were, you know, killed, shot at, you know, in their neck and in their head, in their, you know, in the compound of their houses. So this has been happening all the time, and it seems that, you know, people, the security forces or the government is at war with its own people. That's why things are not improving. They are going from bad to worse. And
in fact, Soil now joins us live with more details on this story and also the latest that you can see on your screens with regards to the at least two people who've been killed. Let's head across to Soil first. Those exclusive pictures that NewsX has been putting up on the screens there of CRPF personnel throwing stones at a residential area. Has there been any sort of reaction coming in from the government on this?
So not so far. In fact, this is for the first time that we have shown on camera. These people have been captured on camera doing what they are being seen to be done. They have pelted stones on the second and third stories of the residential blocks out there, although they were basically engaged in stone pelting and clashes with the protesters who were there, pelting stones on them, and then they retaliated. But once these pelters were, you know, shooed away from that area, they went into the lanes and violence disappeared there. But then you could very clearly see the security personnel, you know, pelting stones on the residential blocks, probably trying to, you know, break down the window panes. And this is something that people have been alleging for quite some time. And in fact, there was an internal inquiry on part of JNK police earlier, which even found that there was some kind of truth in these allegations earlier as well.
And Mehbooba Mufti, of course, coming out, like we just heard a little while ago, talking about how we've seen this before, and she's saying that these pictures now prove her point. Thanks very much indeed. That was Soheil reporting for us from Srinagar.